Doing something different every day. I mean, I may mow today, I may weed eat tomorrow, I may lay sod the next day. It's not your average factory type job to where you're doing the same mundane thing every day. It's something different. I like the people. I love being outside. Yeah, it's hot and it's cold, but I'd rather be outside than sitting in a building. I do like that part of my job.
I pretty much like the people that I work with. I like the building I'm in. Benefits are good. And I like the pride that comes through at Western. You know, you're gonna have some bad apples, but you kind of have to tune them out and don't let them bring you down. So I turn my radio on, I keep to myself on my floor, I do my dancing, my singing, and I do my cleaning.
My coworkers, moving from Butler County to here, it might not seem like a big move, but it was a big adjustment, and the ladies in the office have become more like family. You know, a lot of times I talk to them before I talk to my own family about different things, and we're always there to support each other and sometimes to tell us what we need to hear, you know, even though we might not like it. We have a pretty good relationship, so. Probably my favorite part.
Very good. Favorite part is cleaning through the year, I guess he's trying to say, routine and keeping everything clean. But my favorite part is watching the professors when they brag on what's been done, you know, and when you're doing something, they'll go, oh, Jen, it looks so good, you know. That makes you feel good knowing they give you things to show your appreciation.
Even though I don't like project work, it's rewarding to see the benefits of a nice floor that's been waxed. I mean, it looks really nice.
Mm-hmm. The people I work with.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Most definitely. Yeah.
We always have fun.
It's,
I like working with the students and the directors.
Students are my least favorite part.
Really?
Well, Tom has.
I like them.
Poor Tom. It's okay, Tom. We're here for you.
I just don't believe they like me.
I don't think it's you.
No.
Not all of them are butt heads and make messes, you know, but there is a very fine line between that. I mean, because the ones that you think are so sweet may be the ones that's making this big, huge mess.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, but it's kind of hard sometimes not to get to know the students and things like that.
I like the fact that it's like a small city. I'm never stuck in one place at the same time, and my job is different every day. It's always a challenge. There's always the opportunity to take a preventative measure to see a new way to do something. One unique thing about our job is we're responsive. We have to be responsive. Typically, nobody gets excited until something isn't working or it's doing something it's not supposed to. And so we might be down at service supply 1 minute and then need to run over to Northeast Hall and then get called for something that needs immediate attention at the new parking structure. So it's always there's never a routine. You know, there are some things naturally that have a natural setup to them. When we do the athletic events, there's a routine we go through to set everything up. But during a basketball game, we might have to respond and get a video board working, or might have some sound system issues that need to be resolved. So it's never a sit down and do the same thing every day. And so that's one part about it that I love, not to mention the people. I love talking to people.
The part I like about the job is we work with so many different people. You really get to interact with a lot of people. And also, I like working on a university because it's fun for me watching these young kids come in as freshmen and, you know, in the buildings that we're in, you kind of get to know a lot of the people. And you watch those kids grow up over 4 years and graduate and move on to the real world for them. And that's kind of enjoyable to watch.
I like the environment, academic environment. It's something that I enjoy. Just being in this atmosphere, being around students, being around the professors, it's always interesting to have some conversations with, you know, various people, to learn their backgrounds. You get to meet people literally from all over the world here at the university.
The people, I mean, before me and my dad worked for ourselves and it was kind of rush, and it was just me and him. Now the team environment is new to me and I like it a lot.
It's the people. Mm. I mean, because I started here 24 years ago, and it's the people.
Working with people is the most enjoyable part of it, I think.
The heat and the cold, and I mean, that's just part of it. It's hot in the summer, it's cold in the winter, but that's just elements we have to deal with. So that would be my least favorite thing about the job.
Now that the way paperwork runs and stuff, it's probably not being able to get a job done in a certain amount of time, maybe having to wait for parts and stuff to come in. It's kind of aggravating to have one tore apart and maybe having to worry about parts being out a week or two before you can get things back together. And you sometimes things get misplaced and stuff, or you might have to finish a job up for somebody, they go on vacation and you're waiting for parts and you're not sure where they were at on the job, and you have to kind of step in and go over it and make sure you get everything back together right. But yeah, other than that, that's probably about it.
The thing that aggravates me the most about my job is the lack of communication, sometimes between different areas just within our department. Whether it be with the employees, the supervisors, and a lot of times, sometimes the managers too. There isn't a lot of communication that needs to be done, and it just makes it difficult for everyone in our department whenever that doesn't happen.
Well, if you want to be honest about it, I don't like doing project work.
For me, the worst part of my job is having to clean up things that shouldn't have happened in the first place. Our day is filled, when school's in, our days are filled with mindless vandalism and just plain meanness. And there's no exceptions to it. You have to clean it up. You know, it's on your floor. It's your responsibility. All writing on the walls and holes knocked in the drywall, you know, in the bathrooms,
in pooping the hallway. In the shower, yeah. Pooping on top of the toilet, pooping on the elevator walls. Shall we go on?
Yeah, when somebody kicks a commode off the wall and then it floods from 27 all the way down to the first floor. You have no elevator. You have to pack all your equipment up those stairs.
I had a shower one time that had poop in it, and I had a special dustpan that I used for such situations.
Pooper scooper.
It was down the wall and in the floor. I scraped up what I could and got it in a trash bag and hustled it outside and threw it in the trash compactor. And when I went back upstairs to clean the rest of the shower, somebody was in it.
I actually had, not this past year, but the year before, I had one of my floors filled a complete stove full of urine because they got mad because I said something about them putting bottles of urine in the trash. The RA said something to them and they filled the entire stove with stale urine. Had to be completely taken out. I mean, just disgusting.
We found poop in the ovens
bad stuff
before.
Tampons on the burners. I mean, just...
They'll take the tampons off and just put...
Lay it where it is.
That's the meanest part.
They take the pads off, sticking in the toilet paper dispenser, or on top of it where everybody got a touch. Oh no.
That's what I mean about cleaning up things that shouldn't have happened in the first place. I always said if all I had to do was my job, I'd have it made.
Well, when we came in that morning, the guy at the desk was telling us we had a surprise in the elevator. Well, we already smelt the aroma, so we opened the elevator door and voila! But it takes skill. That was a lot of time and effort to come up with thanking them out, putting it into a patty, and smacking it against the wall, which I feel is totally disrespect for us to have to clean it, but we still have to clean it. And then after we cleaned what we could, the elevator man had to come in and literally take the panel off because it was back up in it.
Yeah, we don't have a procedure for that sort of thing. It isn't written down anywhere. Like I've found vomit in the air conditioner vents, like at the end of the hallways and stuff. There's no procedure for that. You just have to do the best you can.
Sunday mornings after party night, pitiful. You have everything that you shouldn't even see. I have walked in on, you know I ain't playing, people laying in front of the toilet. You don't know if they living or breathing or doing anything, face down, actually in the vomit and stuff. Now, before school let down, it was a guy, he was up on either 7 or 6, I know it wasn't on Melinda's floor, his pants was all the way down to here, and he was face down.
I found him face down in the floor too. There was a story I heard from somebody, some guy in PFT had passed out, and he was laying in the floor in front of the elevator, and the elevator doors, they're open on his head.
You know, the showers and stuff, you have to try to work around the schedule. Everybody's on a different schedule, and you only have a certain length of time to do what you have to do because you have more than one floor. I mean, so they're coming in trying to take showers while you're in there trying to clean. I mean, all I say is if they can be courtesy enough to cover up, you know, I can't stop them.
That's why I try to build a relationship with them, you know. If you show them respect, which, you know, we do give them respect anyway, some of them will give it to you back, but then you got the other ones that, I guess they just train the new ones that come in, but no, you don't do this, you need to do it this way. That's where the conflict is, because you can get some good kids, but then you get that one on that floor. Mm-hmm. Tear up the floor, just because it's the attitude. Nobody's going to do nothing to me. They know this. All the ceiling tiles and stuff, ain't nobody going to do nothing to me. Let's knock them all down. They'll come in and pick them up.
I don't try to establish relationships with them. If they speak, I'll speak. If they're smiling,
it's not more than a relationship. You know, hi, how you doing? But I mean,
yeah.
What gets me is when you speak, they don't acknowledge you.
Yeah. You meet them in the hallways, elevators, and everything, and they're, good morning, sir. How are you? And things. Boy, you sure have to work hard, and things like that. You don't know whether they're the ones that are doing it, or you know, if they really don't like those conditions. Very few of them move because of the conditions. I know one guy that moved from my building to a different building because he didn't like the way people were acting on the floor, you know, making messes and stuff like that.
Well,
but that's
like,
I've only heard that one time.
In my situation, I don't necessarily think with the urine and the stove and stuff, I don't necessarily think it was completely toward me. A lot of times you don't know how these RAs are taking it to them.
Yeah.
You know, it's a lot of, sometimes it has a lot to do with presentation. If they're really buttholes and saying, hey, she said the yada, 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 they're going to be mad, and it's not necessarily directed toward me, but they're not realizing I'm the one that suffers because of their actions. You know, they could be doing it to make the RA mad, or just because they're mad at something that somebody else, you know,
but what
said.
They need to understand is it don't really affect the RA because we have to clean it up.
Yeah.
You can't take that stuff personal. You wouldn't get any sleep if you did.
You know, when they throw food all over somebody's door or shaving cream or whatever, it's not the person that you're doing to that door. You know, they're not the ones that's got to come behind and clean that mess up and then worry about the carpet and everything else that you have to do. So, I mean,
I tell people there's two kinds of people that use the showers after you do. Talk about people leaving their stuff in there. There are two kinds of people. There's the guy who says, oh boy, free shampoo, and uses it himself. And then there's the guy who says, oh boy, free shampoo, and gets drunk and squirts it all over the wall somewhere for fun. You know, if the first guy finds your shampoo, you're screwed. If the second guy finds it, we're both screwed. And, but, you know, one kid asked me, what do you do with the bottles that you find in the shower? I said, I don't do anything with them. They disappear all by themselves. He said, but that means somebody's been stealing my shampoo. Duh. I tell them, don't leave things in the shower or in the bathroom because they won't be there when you come back.
And if they are, they might not be the way you left them.
Exactly.
Yeah, whether somebody did something to it. I mean,
a lot of them, they treat the bathrooms and the kitchens as their own personal storage space. You know, they put stuff in there and they don't ever come back and get it. There's dishes piled up all over the place, and you got to clean around those for a day or two, and then you have to bag them up and stick them under the sink for a few days, and after that, a lot of times they'll get thrown away. They just abandon stuff like that if they don't want to mess with it.
One thing I just despise is climbing the spiral staircase at the bell tower.
I don't know. Never thought about that. Maybe need to do a little better about finding better ways to do sewer stop-ups and stuff, because that can get dangerous, I guess. I don't really enjoy that too much, but not a lot you can do about it at the time, but maybe we should think about ways to do it better in the future. So that's something I would change about what I do here.
Sometimes we run into situations that are hard for us to be able to resolve on our own. It's beyond basically DFM's capability.
I really don't have anything like that. I mean, you know, I've enjoyed being here. I mean, there's ups and downs, you know, and as far as the work, but, you know, start a new day.
Probably some of the really bad sewage issues that we come upon. Some of the little houses that we take care of, it's really old plumbing inside of those, so we get a lot of pretty nasty jobs in those as far as sewage backups.
But I think one of the most difficult things is, as I'm working, if coworkers are complaining, it's just very discouraging.
Keep the grounds clear, debris, clutter, tree limbs, mow, weed eat, sod, maintain flower beds, beautification mainly. Just keep everything looking good.
What I do is, in the winter months, I watch and fire the natural gas boilers. Also in the plant, I also take care of pumps, take care of the softeners when they need to be regenerated. We have a process to run through them to keep make sure our water is soft going to our boilers so they stay in really good shape. Have a DA upstairs that we have to take care of, keep a watch on for pressure and to make sure that the water going to it is in good shape. We have electric motors running through here with fans and stuff like that.
I clean a building. I make sure that the restrooms are sparkling, sanitized. I clean up each of the offices. Make sure everything is presentable for, you know, when visitors attend. If an office is clean, they work better. The customer has a better feeling about their work environment. So I try to keep that dust up and the floors vacuumed and, you know, desks cleaned off and sanitized.
Recently, I just took over the in-house billing, which was Misty Craft. I deal with SRs, inner accounts, invoice requests. I assist with keeping the log of the WKU vehicles, and I work with a couple different people throughout campus with that.
Okay, when school is in, we're all assigned to certain floors in certain buildings, and sometimes that changes, sometimes it'll be the same from year to year. And you basically just take care of cleaning and straightening up the floors that you have to do every day.
Yeah, we work as a team, like the scrubbing and waxing, and then I have a team that does carpet, just different things like that, cleaning bugs out of lights. Inspecting rooms after they clean them. Yeah.
And then we have a lot of different camps and stuff that come in. So we clean the rooms initially to get the buildings ready, you know, a full clean. And then we'll have camps and stuff that come in. So you would work those buildings just like you would during the year, you know, cleaning the common areas. And then, of course, when the students leave from the camp, we have to re-clean those rooms and get the building ready again for school to start back.
Yeah.
You wouldn't believe some of the different things. I mean, it just depends. Oh,
we found a butt plug.
Blow up doll.
Yeah, there was, I found
somebody
a fake
found,
lady part in
yeah,
the kitchen.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. Somebody found
while
a
back.
Yeah. Vibrators, I mean, the list goes on and on.
Yeah,
there you have it. You yeah. asked.
Well, there's typically just two of us in the shop, and we'll do everything from fire alarm systems to access control, sound systems, video boards, e-phone heads, clock systems, any kind of handicap door, any device that might have wires on it that are questionable as if something's working, we'll work on it. So really it's a wide range of systems that we actually work on. And if some of this is seasonal, of course, when football season and basketball season is in full swing, we make sure that the video boards are functioning, the scoreboard controllers are functioning, the sound systems are functioning. So it'll be any, during the off season, like the summertime, we've got six fire alarm panels, actually seven, that we're changing out completely because of their age. So, you know, we'll do anything that might be from preventative board level repair, like James is working on some boards that instead of just throwing them away, we can desolder them, take care of the problems on them, build them back and use them again. And so, I mean, it could be clock system. That's something else we do is the Guthrie bells. So we climb all the way up in the top and work on the bells. So we always have something to do, whether it's the LED lighting up at Cherry Hall, and you can have literally any color you want up there, but we try and limit it because it's a lot to try and program. John Osborne was real good about letting us know what he wanted, but we've got, 16 or 18 different basic color selections. We have a game day theme. We have a graduation theme. There's three different Christmas themes. There's even a Halloween theme, patriotic theme, you know, red, white, and blue, and we can arrange those any way we need to. And of course, you have a couple different levels of white depending on, you know, what we want to do. So bell tower is a little bit different than the bells at Cherry Hall. They both operate off of a carillon, but at the bell tower, it's actual bells that have an actual hammer that strike them, unless it's the four big bells, which are several tons, and they actually have a motor with the chain that makes the bell swing or peal. So the president likes to hit the peel when we win a game, and so we gotta make sure those are working before each game.
I'm the area team supervisor for Area Team 4. So a lot of my job consists of meetings and doling the work orders out to the other guys, and then also, you know, helping them do their jobs and that kind of stuff.
In energy management, and what that is all the building automation systems. We work to control the energy costs for the campus through various, you know, means, you know, using technology. And you know, whatever means possible to reduce, you know, overall utility costs to the university.
Oh gosh, from waiting on people at the window to making out requisitions to ordering parts, calling vendors, getting invoices, calling on vendors to come and bring parts to the stockroom. That's my day right there. That's my day.
You know, I'm a BSA, and I am. Well, when I'm at the Alumni Center, I take care of the first floor, which is all the ballrooms. In the restrooms, I clean, I dust, do windows. Pretty much, I do a lot.
I'm one of five porters of the BSAs, and we go through campus between the other two shifts. So we're going from one building to another, checking on restrooms, make sure there's paper towels, soap, toilet paper.
We do rounds to make sure everything's okay if nothing's pressing, and then you just whatever you got, I guess most pressing, you do that. Maybe mine might be a commode that's running all the time, or a urinal that's running all the time, or stuff like that, plumbing wise, and then just go from there. Lights, ballast, maybe. We've been having a lot of drain stop ups lately. That's always fun. Do a lot of that stuff. But we do everything as far as moving furniture for people, hanging pictures, just anything to keep our students, faculty, and staff happy.
Well, routinely, generally, I get to the building. First thing I do, and of course, it's still night, so I turn on the lights on. I check every room, make sure that there's nothing extra that I have to do, or if there's something that is out of line. So you have a lot more work if the place is a mess. The big thing, I think, it makes life easier if you set yourself a routine.
Well, when we first get here, we clock in and we go to our building and go to our closets and get all of our materials that we need, and then do our routine, and then that's basically it.
Okay. Well, we clean the restrooms. First thing we do when we go in is usually check, because our door glasses, they try to keep the entrance clean. And, you know, then we go in and look at our floors, which with project cleaning, you can't, you know, keep it off till you get it all done, looking really good. But then we go, like you said, get our carts out, get all of our supplies ready, and try to get to the one area which we're cleaning at and take everything there and all work as a team, you know, getting things out of the room and cleaning the room, doing the windows and stripping the floors and waxing the floors right now at this time, and getting it shined up for when the students do come back.
During the school year, when everything is really humming, but I generally wash down all their desks, make sure that as those are disinfected and washed, so they have a clean surface to work on every day. I make sure I vacuum everything, wash all the windows inside and out.
A typical day, it's not hard down there at the Alumni Center, but when you have events like graduation, you have a hard job. And you have to keep up with the ballroom, the carpets, make sure they look really good. It can be hard at times.
A lot of my typical day is just sweeping up toilet paper and paper towel scraps and flushing toilets. But then we get called from time to time to different buildings to clean up spills and take care of other particular needs.
I would say everybody, faculty, staff, students, parents of students. Everything we do for the benefit of everybody. We want the campus looking good, clean. It benefits everybody that works here. That's what I feel.
All the students, 100%. If it wasn't for them, Western wouldn't be here. Try to take care of them as much as possible, nice to them as much as possible, help them out as much as possible. And the teachers, also, I would assume athletics is ours, housing is ours. We pretty much interact with just about everybody on campus.
Our customers with facilities, they're the people who are in my building in the Augustine Alumni Center. So we have the campus visits there. We have events. You have like the board of directors for the Alumni Center. They meet there. We have weddings. So we have a variety of people that come through the building.
Okay. Well, for us, our customers are the faculty and staff throughout campus and in the buildings who call and report to us. The students, they're our number one customer. They're the reason why we are here. So we get calls from either they're in a classroom or in a resident hall. And also, our customers in the front office can also be our maintenance men or BSAs, because we assist them with either the work order system or with their payroll, or sometimes they come to us needing help whenever Shauna isn't here with certain things. So really our customers are our DFM employees, faculty, staff, and our students.
I would say the professors and the students.
I would say the same, because I have a lot of teachers, professors, and they want us to do a little extra to help them out, but they're always looking out for us too. And the students is what makes Western. If it wasn't for them, we wouldn't have a job. And you know, they want things to be like our own home family. They need things, and we're there to help them with that, because the students are good to us too. And that makes it.
Students.
The students.
That's a two-parter for me. The people who actually pay for the service are the customers, which would be the parents, but the people we serve are the students. So the students are the only ones here, so I guess they're the ones we serve.
Well, ultimately, of course, it starts with the students, because we wouldn't have a job if it wasn't for the students. But really, when you get right down to it, with the nature of our work, it's the people that operate in the buildings, whether it's a fire alarm from all the way from a coordinator to getting someone out of the building, to the sound systems or the scoreboard systems at athletics. So really, everybody is our customer.
I would say our staff and faculty and our students, and also other departments, the grounds crew, BSAs, other maintenance crew. We try to keep everybody happy and everything up to par.
I think the students mainly, because we are making the buildings, our buildings, presentable for them. Right. And show how much we care about them and the other people, like the presidents and the other co-workers.
Faculty, the staff, the students, and other departments probably within DFM.
And we're all in the business of taking care of our clients, right? Sodesco is WKU, us is the individual buildings that we're in.
We have several customers, the faculty and staff, our students and their parents, and then we have visitors as well, and many of those are also not from our community, but from other communities in the states, and even many from other countries.
On this campus, we serve everyone, staff, faculty, students, visitors.
Well, the maintenance people, you know, the people that come into the window there and pick up parts, customers. Yep. Maybe we go to dream of the Osaka sun. Oh, 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 oh. Dream of where the morning comes. We'll be right back.
I don't know if they all realize how much trash we pick up, how much there is to actually do to keep the campus clean. I don't think they understand everything we do do. I mean, we do everything from grounds work to moving furniture, going into burning buildings and getting paintings out. I mean, we do whatever's asked of us. And there's a lot of stuff asked of us that don't pertain to grounds work. And I don't think people realize that we do all of that, do all of those things.
There's the manholes that we have all over campus that we get down into. Of course, under the colonnade up here by Fine Arts, steam line runs under it. We actually get into it during the winter time. I believe it's once a week. It has to be walked to check for leaks and all that. We got steam pipe everywhere. We work with housing too. We keep their boilers running and keep the lines and stuff for them.
Everybody has the heat in the buildings to have to worry about. Okay, it gets very warm with very little air coming through there, if any, coming through. But our building, the lights turn off. We could be in a stairwell and the lights just will go off every hour on the hour. We could be in the restroom and the lights turn off. We have to actually, it's not a censored light. We have to actually go and turn the light back on. And it may take us 5 minutes to turn the light on, but it's a big safety issue there. There is no lighting at all.
I mean, in our office, we're all trained, we're cross-trained to do someone else's position. So, of course, I worked in the work control position, so I'm able to do everything with that job. And probably the one that made me the most mad and aggravated for our employees was, I think it was over at South Campus somewhere, which just happens all over campus. Someone spilled water. And it was just porters at the time. It was afternoon, and it's really hard to find someone to go do, go clean or clean a mess or a spill afternoon because the porters are like two to cover all of campus. And they spilled water, and we had to send someone over there with the paper towel and just wipe up the water. We've had birds, another one, dead bird on the sidewalk. Maybe I'm just country, but we just kick it out of the way. I mean, but we have to send Larry Johnson to go put gloves on, pick up the bird and throw it in the trash. We've had some that Rachel was telling me, squirrels hanging around a building. And they didn't want the squirrels hanging around the building. So Larry had to go with the cage, catch the squirrels and relocate them to a different area. There's squirrels, they're all over campus, so.
Yeah.
They were just scaring them, I guess. They're pretty harmless. If you don't bother them, they won't bother you.
What about bats?
Bats in ceilings. We have a lot of residents who think they hear stuff in the ceiling, and they'll put in work orders, and we'll send Larry all over the place, and he can't find anything, which happens the majority of the time. But there are bats everywhere. We've had a bat in our office. We had the back door open because either the heating or the cooling wasn't working, something. So we had the door open and a bat flew into our office. And I actually have a videotape of it. It's pretty hilarious.
Those unexpected things happens in your building, urinals run over, we have to get someone to, you know, it's something. And like with professors, they may want something extra done. Well, she wanted the tables moved. One of the table legs were broke, and she wanted that table took out, and another top brought in. Where some of the people that work there says, hey, we don't do that work. You don't lift this, you know. But you're not looking at how you're helping to satisfy her, because if you do for them, they're going to, you know, want to help you in your daily job. And some of them don't want to. You know, I think you should always be respectful to them. And if you can't lift it, there's a thing you can push to help save your back, put it on it and roll it to her. You know what I'm saying. There's ways you can satisfy the customer and be nice to them, even though you might not like having to do the extra work. That's, you know.
Yeah.
For me and Tom, we do a lot of stripping and waxing. I run it during the summer. So me and Tom been on for about the last 3-4 years together. So right now, we was at Barnes having real major problems. Apparently they put sealant on the floors that they put in a couple of years ago, and you can't put sealant on a floor that you're gonna wax. So now we are forced to scrape, strip, and boost, and you name it. Wow. We have spent, for me, 1 week on one floor. From Sunday to the next Sunday, I was on this floor. One floor.
We had to try several different, techniques, ways to get rid of it, mixtures on the stripper, and how long we let it sit, and till we finally came up with a system that worked the best. It's not perfect, but at least we're moving now, and we weren't before. We were just kind of stuck on one floor trying to figure it out.
I mean, I know that, like, on the outside of the building, grounds and stuff will come by with their mowers and their seeds and their fertilizer and stuff, and, you know, that stuff gets tracked into our building, too. If it's blowed or cut or whatever, and it's close, and, you know, and it's not cleaned off, we have to either clean that up or deal with it when we clean it up on the inside. I mean, you know, that's like one of those things that, you know, you have to have the grass mowed, you have to have the fertilizer, and you have to have all that. But we're cleaning that mess up also.
I had a kid ask me one time, could we install some stronger shower curtain rods so they could do chin-ups? he was serious.
Yeah, too. Sure.
Told him I'd see what I could do.
I had one young man ask me, could I clean his room?
All the time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Can you clean our room? When are you going to come clean our room?
Mm-hmm.
One of them actually asked me, when do you come and clean the room?
Yeah.
I mean, we'll be asked to do anything from put up a projector, which we might do once in a great while. We've got a work order for 2 projectors to put up right now. To something unusual over at baseball where we had to repair the radar gun for the speed of pitch. So every now and then there's something that just pops up that we might do once a year, or something unusual, or somebody wants a different way to monitor something, so we fabricate something to work. So it might be the monitoring of a door in a particular way that we don't do anywhere else. There's those unusual things that always pop up. The most interesting thing that I did one time, Herb and I were working together, and we had to go up to the bell tower and, for the first time, I believe, really work on the operation of the bells that peel, because people don't realize how big they are. You're talking several tons on one bell, a couple tons on another bell, and we're struggling to get everything set up so we could work it. So we thought we would activate the motors while we're up there on just 2 of the bells, on just 2 of them, opposite sides. And of course we're excited when they started working, but there's such a swing up there that the bell tower, this was just with 2 of the bells going, the bell tower, you could feel the whole thing moving, and they say it moves, and I believe it, a total of 6 inches. So when all 4 bells are going, the bell tower is actually moving around. I couldn't get down fast enough out of the ladder. Of course, after the spiral staircase, there's the 15 or 20 foot ladder, rung ladder, that when they mounted it, it's at an angle. So you climb up on the wrong angled side to get up into the top of it. And when it started moving, I couldn't wait to get down. And but from the ground, you can't tell it's moving, but it's designed to sway. So when you get 8 or 9 tons up there moving around, believe it or not, that whole thing moves.
Here recently, put on a Tyvek suit and a face shield and climbed up in a ceiling to clean out a drain. A lot of mess, a lot of fun. I'm sure a lot of people don't know we go through such extent to clean out a drain, but it can get pretty bad. Maybe other departments or my family, most of all, they think all I do is plumbing, but we all do everything. Like, an electrician might help me do plumbing, or I might do change ballast, change the lights. I mean, we do a little everything. I mean, there's nothing that we turn down. I mean, unless we just don't have the tools to do it. But if we can do it, we'll try to get it done. I mean, there's nothing like, I don't just do plumbing. You know, our electrician just don't do electric. I mean, we try to help each other out, get the job done, whatever it is. I mean.
Actually, where I am in houses, interaction with your client is a lot more important than I think any other place, because they're right there with you. And especially now that we're doing project work, I mean, you were there while they were working, so you really got to watch. Like, I was scrubbing bathroom today. I made sure I closed the door to the bathroom, and I worked inside the bathroom because that scrubber was just humming. And they might be on the phone, they may be, you know, having a meeting, and last thing they want to hear is that thing. You just got to go with the flow. Cleaning is cleaning, any way you look at it. The methods are different in some instances, but the work is still the same, and you got to do it. And that's the key. So the best thing to do is just do your job, get it done.
At Alumni, we have to come in and do those events. If they've got an event the next day, you know, like 8 o'clock in the morning, it has to be totally cleaned that night. And a lot of times, we only get 2 to 3 hours to clean that. Some people don't realize that.
A lot of our job, too, is kind of public relations stuff. You know, we try to keep the building occupants happy. We do a lot of things, from hanging pictures to moving furniture to you name it. I mean, we've done quite a bit of different jobs for people just to keep them happy. Yeah, a couple weeks ago we had a call to remove a futon from a visiting scholar residence that was covered in bed bugs. We helped Larry Johnson. He sprayed the bed bugs and we had to remove the futon.
People don't realize how much paperwork goes on back here, that the auditors are so picky about, you know, stuff that we do back here. It's quite a bit involved. Sometimes I'll be on the phone, you know, an hour or more, you know, trying to track people down for invoices. But that's my day.
Well, Angie is incorporating something with our office, our team. In the front office. Every day we are going to be calling customers out on campus that have requested work orders. So like I'm on Mondays. So all the work orders that were completed on that previous Friday, we go through and look, and if they're requested by people out on campus, not interdepartment, we're going to choose, I think it's 10 work orders, and call them, ask them how their service went, if the work was completed, you know, was it completed in a timely fashion, just to get a better understanding of each other and communicate better with our staff and people out on campus. So we're really looking forward to it, just because I think we have a certain stereotype here to where we don't care about people out on campus, we don't care about, you know, what they think about our work or what we think about our work. But really, I take pride in doing my work correctly.
Maybe communication on, or a better description on work orders. I think that would be helpful. Maybe put more specifics on what's wrong and what needs to be done or where it's at. I think that would help out.
I don't know in particular, other than if people would just take a extra moment to take a look around and verify some things.
You know, a lot of stuff comes back to the communication factor. You know, just communicating locations and descriptions on work orders, you know, that kind of thing. For the most part, though, I think we all work together really well around here as a team.
Working cohesively and together to reach a certain goal. And I think our goal here is to please our customers, which is our staff, our faculty, our students, and our fellow employees.
Everybody needs to get along, you know, try to work together, everybody, and try to agree on everything. No arguing, you know. You always have a difficult one, though.
We do a lot more team stuff in the summer.
When
school's in, I'm by myself all day long. And I don't have to interact with other employees. But in the summertime, we're pretty shoulder to shoulder a lot of the time. Whether you're stripping floors or cleaning rooms, you're going to have to get along with somebody.
And it makes a long day if you don't.
Yeah.
Being a part of a team involves the efforts of everyone. You know, DFM as a whole is a team. You know, various people that will specialize in one thing or another, but it takes everyone to do what is necessary to get the job done. For the most part, I think that there are, you know, the majority of the people do work very well together. I think that there are some good effort put forth by everyone. You know, we work across the board with people with other skill sets, you know, electricians, HVAC techs, you know, it's, you're just one person within the larger picture, one gear in the whole transmission that makes everything run. Right. I think for the most part, we do work as a team. You know, everyone has projects and things that they need to get accomplished, and, you know, we have to work together to get our, you know, to get the priorities of things taken care of, but for the most part, I'd say that we do.
Being a part of the team, everyone should pitch in. To me, a team is there to help you out. There is some people that don't pull their weight, and that makes it harder on some of the others.
Because, you know, we all work together, you know, and we all communicate. Everybody, we work together and to get the job done, you know. Mm-hmm. That's you know, here at the university, you know.
Right.
It seems like everybody works to a common goal, you know, which is...
Teamwork to me means you have a big job to do, and if everyone can do their own little part of that big job, the jobs get done, and it makes it easier on the whole team. To, you know, not one guy doesn't have to do everything on his own. Everyone can chip in their own part.
Being a part of the team, it's I think because we have such a big task, taking care of all the facilities, the grounds, the utilities and such, as DFM, just the immensity of it is a difficult thing, but just being able to work together and encourage each other and try to have an enjoyable time together at work, I think that's a good part of the work.
And I asked some of my other coworkers, hey, you guys need help? And that's part of being part of a team, that, hey, you know, I'm free, you need any help? If they say no, well, fine. If they say yes, I'm right there.
I think it makes you feel good when you accomplish something as a team. And a lot of what we do is done as a team. A lot of it's done individually. But when you all work together, and we've done it on several occasions, when everybody works together, you get a lot accomplished in a short amount of time. And I like that aspect of the job.
Back to haunt me, and I realize
So I cry.